Hey guys, it's Vance. Before I hand it over to Jonathan and Jaylen, be sure to stick around to the end of the video for a surprise sneak peek from the South family and myself at our upcoming holiday special. See you guys there.
Hi everyone, welcome back to Cover to Cover with Jay and Jay. I'm Jaylen.
And I'm John. And this is the show where we talk about everything you want to learn about the marching arts.
Before we bring out Vance today, our special guest, we want you to go and subscribe to all of our channels so you can get all of the notifications for all of our new series.
Yeah.
Did you see the twirl around the world video with the Big Ten twirlers? I thought it was so cool because I love Big Ten football. Lexi was able to have all of the featured twirlers in one place, and all of them are participating in the Intercollegiate Marching Band.
Yeah. So, as many of you know, CBDNA and GPG Music, in conjunction with Style Plus, Halftime Magazine, CollegeMarchingBand.com, Guard Closet, and Fanraise, are bringing together college and university marching bands from all over the country for one massive virtual performance.
So to keep up with all of the news with all of these amazing projects, go and subscribe to youtube.com/styleplusband for all of the content. Let's bring out Vince.
Thank you for having me.
Hello.
Great to have you.
Thank you.
So, Vance, thank you for coming on our show. We always ask our guests this. So, first question is going to give us birth till now 20-second bio. Boom, go.
Okay. I was born in Las Vegas, Nevada. I moved to Japan when I was 4 because my dad was in the military. I lived there for 4 years. I moved back to Las Vegas to live there for one more year. Then I moved to Florida where I lived in the Panhandle for 10 years. That's where I started doing color guard. And then in 2014 until now, I have lived in Orlando, Florida.
Wow.
Miracle pop, you got it all in one.
Right, that was 10 seconds, that wasn't 20.
Yes, I'm impressed by that. So I want to kind of hear how you started in the arts and everything. I kind of heard how you bounced all over kind of everywhere, basically. Mm-hmm. So I kind of want to hear how you've taken stuff you've learned from traveling and moving around and placed it into what you do today.
So growing up in the Air Force, I never really had an opportunity to like stay in one place for that long to like really ground my roots into something that I liked. Once I moved to Florida though, that was when my dad retired from the military and we actually got to stay in Florida. So I like went to school and like all throughout high school, I got to stay in like the same place. And that's where I originally started in band and I played the flute in middle school and in high school. And then one day I was best friends with a girl in the color guard. And she was like, you should try this out. And I was like, no, I really shouldn't try that out. And she's like, no, you should try it out. And I was like, okay, I guess I'll try it out. So then I tried and I started spinning a rifle and I could do drop spins, which is really super fundamental. And I would like do them like at the speed of light with the worst technique, just throwing that piece of wood all over the place. From there, I took a rifle home one day without like nobody knowing. I would spin it in my backyard for hours, just like every other boy in the activity starts doing. And I just like fell in love with it. I started doing color guard. I switched schools my senior year to be in a world guard. And then from there, I like fell like head over heels in love with the activity.
Aw, I love that story. That was great. I like, with all the guests we've had on this channel, I feel like they've all started at a pretty young age or either in high school, but to learn how they transitioned into it and the people that have helped them along, I think that's so great. But I think Jonathan's gonna ask you a very fun question next.
Yes, so we know that you have a YouTube channel and it's so much great content on there. We wanna know why did you start doing this channel? Like what made you wanna just record everything and show it to the world?
So originally, like, I'm just like every other person that does color guard and likes to post on like social media and Instagram and all that stuff. I really like to like create stuff for people to enjoy watching and I like to entertain people. And as soon as like COVID hit, I would normally just like post like routines of me like spinning and doing all this fun stuff and like trying to impress people by doing like all these hard tricks and stuff and like trying to do the next hardest thing in the activity. But like as soon as COVID hit and like people stopped liking color guard as much, I guess, and like they stopped posting and like it didn't seem like it was for what we love to do it for. It seemed like it was just for like the competition and we wanted to be marching the best place and all this stuff. I was like, I just want to do color guard to entertain people and I want to be an entertainer. I don't want to be categorized as just someone that does color guard or just someone that spins a rifle, saber, or a flag. I just wanted to make people smile. I wanted people to share my videos and share them with people that didn't do color guard so that they could enjoy it too. And to like kind of open up this bubble that the marching arts is like stuck in competitively. Like I feel like we only do like some stuff competitively and I want to be an entertainer and I want to be color guard. I want color guard to be like the same level that dance and all this stuff is at, like broader, included in more things.
Yeah, I think that's so great. Especially I came from the dance world and I, with everyone that has come on, I've learned so, so much. But I think something that I've recognized is you see this show is about dancing and the competitive dancing, but this in it of itself is like a whole other world. And I think doing this channel and the channels that are on Style Plus, it makes it so amazing to kind of give it to viewers for them to be able to see how much work goes into this. But with that being said, we have a clip from one of your videos. So we're going to show our viewers and we're going to take a look.
Action, baby!
When I'm feeling lonely, sad as I can be, all by myself in uncharted island in an endless sea. What makes me happy fills me up with glee. Those bones in my jaw that don't have a flaw, my shiny teeth and me. My shiny teeth that twinkle just like the stars in space. My shiny teeth that sparkle and beauty to my face. My shiny teeth.
So good. Yes, round of
applause.
I loved the transitions and the intro in the beginning was so cute. I think that's adorable. Oh, I definitely, I feel like it entertains and brings a smile on people's faces. I love it. That was great. That was so good.
Need somebody, call me up. I'm on my way to Florida.
Yeah. And the aesthetic in the background, I mean, come on. Can't get better.
Right. Oh, thanks so much.
But now let's have a little fun because we always have this every single time. We did a social media. So I went on your Instagram, wherever your social media is, and I found three pictures that I just thought were very interesting, and I wanted a little bit more from it. So let's go from the first picture and let's just see
it.
Boom, great. So I know what Blast is. Jaylen, I'm pretty sure, does not. So explain this. I know how high of a prestige honor it is to be in this, like in Blast. So just give me how you're experiencing it. Anything you want to talk about it, because I think it's gonna be great.
So Blast is basically a touring show that includes like the activities of the marching arts. So there's percussion players, there's horn line players, there's people from the color guard that are called the visual ensemble, there's baton twirlers, all these things combined into one touring show that's more of like a Broadway, like entertaining kind of musical show that travels across wherever the tour is.
Oh, wow.
It's like
Broadway geek, I love it. So
yeah. I love that.
I need to go watch. That's so cool. So do you say around the world or the country? I'm sorry.
It depends. There are different tours depending on the year and whatever tour they're doing. This past, the tour that I was a part of was in Japan.
Oh, that's so awesome.
It was really cool.
It's so cool. I always like hear people that got into it, and I know it's like so hard for the audition process and everything, and I just think it's so cool. Maybe one day I'll try and put myself out there, but
yeah.
Tip my hat to you guys. It's
actually a really funny story because my roommate, who's currently my roommate now and was my roommate before, she texted me one day and she was like, hey, I need help writing an audition piece. And I was like, okay, sure, I'll help you. And I was like, for what? And she's like, it's for Blast. And then 5 minutes later, she was like, hey, do you want to audition for Blast?
Wow. I just love the like audition process. And did you go through like one or did you go through multiple or how does that work?
So the audition process was really quick and like fast paced and kind of stressful because we had to get our audition. We did it through video. We had to get our audition videos in like ASAP because they wanted to like get this cast filled right away. Michael Rosales is the one that actually contacted me. He was on your show before. He contacted me and he was like, hey, if you're not doing anything this summer, like this is what we need from you. If you want to audition, we'd love to have you because I've worked with Michael before. He's like, we'd love to have you. We've like kind of know your skill set, but we need to put together a formal audition. So we had to like record all these videos, write choreography, show technique. We had to do an acting scene. We had to sing in it. It was a lot, but it was a lot of fun to put together.
Oh, I love it.
So cool. Love that so much. So that was great. Next picture, let's see it. Yes.
Cool. I love this one.
Yes, me too. I love the makeup, the costume, the everything. Just give me it. What is it about?
A photo shoot. And the makeup actually took like 2.5 hours. I was just sitting in that chair. They had to like glue my eyebrows down like I was on like RuPaul's Drag Race or something. And the makeup artist was just like going at my face for 2.5 hours. We actually didn't even end up using that photo in the catalog. I ended up wearing a snare drum like I was in indoor percussion. But my mom did end up getting me that picture framed on a canvas and it's sitting up in my room right now.
I love that. That's so sad that they didn't put it in the catalog.
No, come on now.
All right, third picture, let's see. Boom.
Oh, what a throwback.
Oh my goodness.
I know you said that you were in the band. Well, I was going to ask you what this picture is from, but you said earlier that you played flute, right?
I did.
Go ahead, go.
That picture though is actually from like something we did for Color Guard. At the high school that I went to, or that I graduated from, Choctachee High School, there's like a tradition where the Color Guard is like toy soldiers, and we do this like toy soldier skit in like the Christmas concert. And it was like a really big deal because like I had switched to this school for my senior year, and I was like, oh my God, I'm gonna get to be a part of this great tradition. I get to wear this cute little costume that's been around for ages and do this like, it's the same exact routine every single year. And it's been like that for like years and years and years.
I was just about to say, it reminds me of the Rockettes and the wooden soldier piece that I watched last night on the little spectacular they had. I loved it. But yeah, it was great. But my favorite part of Cover to Cover is what we do at the end of every episode, and it's our 3-2-1 pose. So on the count of three, you can do whatever you want. And here we go. Ready? Yes. 3-2-1 pose. Love it. So good. Here's a thumbnail. Great.
Love that.
Thank you so much for coming on today.
Again, thank you so much for spending time with us today. It was really great meeting you. For everybody who's watching, go subscribe down in the description to Style Plus Band. We have so many great videos that you can watch. And then after you've done that, go to Instagram and check out Vance at Vance Anderson, and go and also follow Style_Plus_Band. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next week. Yeah!
Birds of a feather would be. Let's take the road before us and sing a chorus or two. Come on.